What's up, guys? Welcome back to a fantastic chemistry podcast. My name is Pete. I'm your host, and we have a co-host. His name is Tuskin. Okay. How you guys doing so far? I'm doing great. I'm so excited. So it's been fun so far. And if you like this podcast, so don't forget to click like, subscribe, leave a comment, and tell your friends and family so they'll watch my video. Okay. All right. Let's get in further. So now we're going to move on to the molecular representation. Okay. So in the previous video or the videos before that, we've been drawing quite a bit of molecules. All right. So, but if you think about even drawing a larger molecules, look something like this. Drawing molecule it could get tough. I mean, there are too many carbons, too many hydrogen there. All right. So we call this representation is a full structure. Okay. Larger molecule is even more complicated than that. Now we try to come up with a representation of this molecule, something that more convenient, take less time to draw. We have a partially condensed or condensed structure. Yeah. You see a few type. I have a few examples. Okay. But it's still get complicated, even a larger molecule. So we try to minimize time and make it more convenient by drawing a lot of time. You're going to draw a bond line structure, something like that. Okay, look something like this. You can see now a bit about bond line structure that we ignore hydrogens. You don't see any hydrogen atoms. All right, and each angle of this bond line structure represents each carbon. Okay, so we ignore hydrogen atoms. We substitute carbon with the angle in this drawing, right? But we keep hetero atoms, keep nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, halogens there, right? We just carbon and hydrogen usually takes time the most to draw. Okay, bond line structure is really convenient because it's faster, much faster than these two. But it could be confusing as well if you don't know how many carbon, how many hydrogen are there, if you can't read it, all right? Well, we don't have any other way. You got to be familiar with it. Let's try this together, okay? At the top, this is a condensed structure. I will ask you to draw, can you read it, convert that to a full structure, and then convert that to a bond-like structure, okay? All right, let's start with the full structure. So start with this carbon right here. This is CH3, look like that. Right, I'm sure you can see that now. Next carbon right here. Remember though, carbon have four bonds, right? Carbon have four bonds. Count that, all right? So one bond to the carbon. So carbon right here. So one bond to this carbon. And the other three gonna be bonded with oxygen, okay? So we're gonna go double bond O and O, look like that, okay? This oxygen right here, if you say, remember oxygen group six, two bonds. Okay, one bond to carbon, the other bond to the other carbon, the CH3 right there. Looks something like that, okay? All right, now, convert full structure to a bond-like structure, right? When you draw a bond-like structure, follow a beehive like that. I'm sure you guys are familiar with beehive, so we go, let's say the start right there, we go beehive, look like hexagon, look just like that, and just beehive coming down, look like that. So you just follow this pattern. Okay, don't make a hexagon look weird. Okay, try to make it look like nice and beautiful hexagon, so you won't get confused. All right, now let's say we're gonna convert this full structure to a bond line structure. I label this carbon 1, 2, and 3. Okay, all right, first line, that's carbon 1, carbon 2. Draw the line up like that. That's 1 and 2. Okay, now this carbon 2 right here connect to the oxygen, this oxygen right here. So we go that oxygen right there. This carbon 2 also have double bond O, put double bond O at the top. Okay, all right, now this oxygen right here is bonded to CH3. So this carbon number 3, oh, that's carbon number 3. Yeah, that's exactly, that's how we draw it. All right, so if you can read from condensed structure or full structure, you can convert to bond line structure easily. But the problem is you students have a hard time read these two structures, okay? Oh, let's try one. Oh, before we go further, so what functional group is this? Anyone knows? Tick tock. Yep, C double bond O and O, that's an ester, okay? You probably have seen C double bond O, OH, that's carboxylic acid. That's only an acid functional group in like the whole functional group there. This is ester, C double bond O and O, all right? Okay. All right, now try this one right here. Okay, so start with this first carbon right there. Now CH3, there are two of them bonded to CH right here. Can you see that? CH3, there are two CH3 group. There are two CH3 group bonded to that carbon. Look like that. So CH group right here. This is CH, this carbon right here. All right. Carbon right here also have four bonds. Right. So 1, 2 go to CH3. 4 go to hydrogen. The other one gonna go to the oxygen next to it. Look like that. All right. Say one more time. Carbon have four bonds. All right. So two bond go to 2CH2. Third bond go to hydrogen, and the last bond go to oxygen. Look like that. Yeah. CH3, hydrogen and oxygen, so four bonds total. Now go to oxygen right here. All right, we're gonna go to oxygen. So oxygen have two bond, 1, 2, CH, this guy right here. On the right side go to CH2. And CH2 is connected to CH3. All of them have four bonds. Okay. All right, now we're going to draw the bond line structure here. So I'm going to label. Labeling helps you the most, especially at the beginning. If you're not familiar with the bond line structure yet, highly recommend label carbon like that. Okay, I have carbon 1, 2, oxygen 3, and 4. Okay, all right, first line, carbon 1, carbon 2, draw up like that. All right, carbon 2 bonded to CH3 and the oxygen. So CH3 up and then oxygen down. All right, oxygen connect to carbon 3, so go up, carbon 3 go to carbon 4, come down, look like that. All right, okay, so number 2, all right, go to this example, start with the condensed structure, start with that carbon, this carbon right here, CH, carbon have 4 bonds, so 2 to the hydrogen, the other 2 double bond there, okay, so you should get that. That's 4 bonds to for this carbon. Next carbon, so 2 bond to the carbon on the left side and 1 to the hydrogen and 1, 2 to the other carbon. Look like that. Okay. Next one, CH2. That should be easy. And the next one, this carbon right here. So watch out. This guy doesn't have hydrogen, right? It's in the middle of carbon on the left, and we have 3 CH3, right? 3 CH3. Look like that. Okay. All right. Now that's a full structure. Take some time to draw. Now convert to something easier. Bond line structure. I'm going to label carbon real quick. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Start with carbon 1, carbon 2, double bond. Look like that. Go to carbon 3, come down. Go to carbon 4. All right. Now watch out though. Carbon 4 is a branch chain here. So carbon 4 branch to 3CH3 group. Okay, look like that. So I'm going to go to carbon 5 and carbon 4 and CH3 at the top. One more time, if you confused what I just say, all right, go back right here. So carbon 4 right here. So carbon 4 connect to carbon 5. So I'm draw one line down here to carbon 5. And on carbon 4, we got 2 CH3 group on it. Okay, I'm going to draw look like that. You can, some of you do point one of the CH3 down, it's fine, all right? But I'm trying to make it a tetrahedral. If you still remember, all these carbon have a tetrahedral geometry. That's a tetrahedral, looks something like that, okay? You can use the wedge line and dash line to make a 3D structure. You will see this much more later in chapter 3 or 4, okay? You can make it a 3D structure there. So be familiar with it, okay? All right, last example. So start with the CH3. I'm sure you can get it now. Next one. So carbon with a triple bond, look like that. So 4 bonds, everyone have 4 bonds. Next carbon also have triple bond and then bond to CH2. And the last one, CH3. Okay. All right, so let's do a bond line structure. But before that, let's label carbon real quick. So carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. All right, first line, draw it up, 1 and 2. Draw right there. Now, here's the thing though, 2 and 3, draw straight line like that, and here's the reason. If you still remember in Gen Chem, a triple bond is linear, right? A triple bond is linear, so you don't do a hexagon line like that. We're not going to do like a bend like that, so keep it straight, okay? So carbon 2 and 3, so 2 and 3, now 3 to 4, also a straight line, All right, so carbon 4 is CH2, so two hydrogen there. This is a tetrahedral now, so we can bend it right here. So carbon 5 down there. All right, okay. Let's stop it right here. So next video is going to be the practice more bond-like structure. It takes some time, but yeah, hang in there, okay?